What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're talking one wheel again here in the garage, and today we're going to be talking about one wheel pint accessories. Top three accessories I would get first when you get your one wheel pint. And stick around because I've got a bonus accessory that you may not think you need, but I think is pretty important. Let's get into it. So I'm sure, like many of you, your interest in a one wheel was piqued when Casey Neistat posted this video, right? Hoverboard with a go-kart tire. I mean, what's not to want to click on that? But then you started seeing other creators like Peter McKinnon, Matty Hapoya, Jesse Driftwood, Cody Wanner, all rolling around on these awesome hoverboards. And if you're like me, you thought, you gotta have one. But then you looked it up and the price tag was just a little bit bigger than you wanted to be. So last year they came out with the one wheel pint. The one wheel pint. It's the smaller little brother version, and it does everything that the one wheel XR does with a little bit less range. I mean, who wouldn't want to float around like Marty McFly on a hoverboard?
Look, I need to borrow your hoverboard.
That sounds like a dream come true for anybody born after 1985. While I wouldn't say this one is cheap, it's half the price of the XR. So I saved up for this, and investing in something like this really makes you want to protect it, right? Now don't get me wrong, Future Motion has made a super durable, awesome, off-roading baby XR right here. This thing is going to last. If you could take some extra precautions and make it last a little bit longer with less maintenance, would you? So the first accessory, and it's not even one that's on the list, that you should definitely get is a helmet. Protect your head, protect your brain, protect yourself at all times. But today we're gonna talk about accessories specifically for the one wheel, right? Specifically to put on the one wheel. The first one that I wanted was this guy, the fender. This is gonna be there to keep from rocks and dirt and dust and water and sticks and leaves, all kinds of things, from flying up around the wheel and up on your leg as you stand on the board. Now, this is the one wheel fender. This is the one that I went with because they had the color that I wanted. And at the time, I didn't think I would ever wanna remove it. So this one is attached permanently through four screws on the top. Craft & Ride has a magnetic one for the pint. And I've watched a couple of reviews on that and it looks solid. Comes in multiple colors again. So if you think that maybe you would want to remove this on a sunny day, or maybe only put it on when it's rainy or you're going off-roading, maybe that's for you. I'll put the links for everything down in the description, so make sure you check those out. So the second accessory I decided I wanted, which is the first one specifically to protect the board, is actually underneath the board. You can't even see it when you're riding. It is the Float Life Float Plate. You see it there. And the reason I got this is because I, much like you probably, have watched a bunch of videos on one wheels and one wheel pints and people hopping curbs and doing all kinds of crazy things. And the one thing I noticed is that these fenders here, where that hold the lights and that house the brain and all the circuits in here, they get really torn up. So I want to protect that so this thing lasts as long as possible. And I would much rather replace this big flat piece here. So these are made by Float Life. They're one solid piece. There's a big piece of adhesive here in the back. They send you extra long screws so that you can screw this guy in. And then it also gives you this little handle here so that you can pick it up and carry it that way. Albeit not very thick. Let me see. See if I can show you here. It's only about a third of an inch thick there. So you can see that, like, even when you go to put your hand in it, you really only get like your fingertips in there, right? You're not getting very much of your hand in there. But it is good if you're just trying to, you know, pick it up off the ground or move it off the table. So this handle wouldn't be something I would use to carry the board very far. I mean, the pint comes with this really great mag handle here, which is awesome for picking it up and carrying it around like a little suitcase. Ideally, I'd rather ride it everywhere. I don't want to carry it anywhere because it's still 20 something pounds of awesomeness. But you could if you needed to. And finally, the most recent accessory, I got a video for it right here if you want to check it out, is these guys right on the side here. You'll notice that you can't see where it says pint anymore, right? It's not a generic color. I've got this really cool black camo reflective sidekick on there. And these are just, again, for the board's protection. This is something I didn't think I would need to invest in, but after riding for a few months, I noticed that this thing has a tendency to wanna like roll onto its side when you jump off or when you have to bail. But not only are they gonna protect it, they're also reflective, right? So it gives it a little bit of a safety feature as well as a cool factor. Again, I got these from the Float Life. They've got multiple colors, so you can change the color of your fender. You can change the color of your float plate. You can change the color of your Sidekick. So you can create a one-of-a-kind custom one wheel with all of these color options. These are just the first three that I would get to make sure that your board is gonna last as long as possible. All right, if you stuck around this long, my bonus feature that I would make sure that you get is something that a lot of people overlook. It's right here on the back. It's this little guy. This little guy is your charger plug, right? It's just a little piece of rubber that shoves right into your charging port and keeps it from getting any dirt or water or anything in there to keep it from charging. Yeah, I watched one YouTuber who got mud in all of these two areas here and they couldn't turn their one wheel on. Now, it wasn't a one wheel pint, but I still think that better safe than sorry in this instance is a pretty good deal. So pick up one of these guys. They're like $3, right? Well, I mean, again, get whatever color you want. Hey, those are my top three accessories for the one wheel pint. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see more content like this or maybe some fitness content, make sure you subscribe, click the bell, do all the things, leave a comment, a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Later.